All right, Antonio, obviously competing yet again in Montreal. This is where you started your career, and you went to Japan. Now you're back to Montreal again. Is it sort of a deja vu competing here? You competed in Canada in your last event. Like, what's going through your mind now that you're back in Canada?
It's a good feeling. I mean, this whole Team Canada vibe is pretty cool, and the fact that I'm seeing all these familiar faces, and we're all here in this room, and we're looking at each other going, man, it's been a long time, but we're all here. We're all doing what we do, and doing it well and loving it the whole time. So this is an awesome experience.
Taking on Rodrigo Damm, a very tough fighter in all aspects. I mean, there are certain levels where you are superior. There are certain levels where he's going to give you a good fight. How do you assess your opponent on Saturday night?
He's good all around, obviously. Very experienced guy, been all over the world. Very similar to me in terms of his career, how it's kind of turned out. He's had a lot of stiff fights already. So this kind of competition for him is very normal. I know the camp he's training out of. You know, in fact, his trainers are actually my Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu instructor trains out of that gym as well, or teaches out of that gym. And so we're all kind of familiar with each other. It's funny because his coach actually came up to me and said, "Oh, I'm sorry," because we got all kind of come from the same line. But I told him it's okay. You know, we're professionals, but at the end of the day, we go perform, entertain people, and then just be friends at the end. And I respect Rodrigo big time. I think he's he's had a hard road here, and he's here and great on the ground. Fantastic pedigree of jiu-jitsu. Striking's constantly improving. You saw it in his last fight. He landed that punch, and that's actually what set up the choke, really, was the punch. It was great timing. He does things as much as they're simpler, I think, than what I do, but they're very effective, and I have to be careful with him. He can get wild, but I think he's kind of matured in that respect, and he's a lot more efficient with his striking.
Well, you mentioned being efficient with striking. After your first, your octagon debut, there was talk that, Carvalho's striking was too rigid. It doesn't extend his arms. The next thing you know, you come back and you knock out an amazing fighter in Daniel Pineda. So the next question is, what about your ground game? Do you have a ground game? I know for a fact. I mean, knowing you so long, but people are going to start questioning your ground game next, don't you think?
It's always like that. You're only as good as your last fight, right? So it is what it is. The truth is, I mean, he's got a better pedigree than I do in terms of competitive jiu-jitsu. I'm confident in my jiu-jitsu. I have never been submitted in an MMA fight. So I'm very confident in my skills to defend against it. If this guy catches me, if Rodrigo catches me, then he's just the better guy. And it must have been a good sub.
George St. Pierre taking on Carlos Conde. We have no idea who the champion is. We have no idea who the challenger is. All we know is George St. Pierre has not competed in over 18 months. Everyone's saying he has to finish the fight. I mean, you and I and Justin and everyone have talked about this before. There are varying opinions amongst our own clan here. I don't think he needs to finish the fight. He needs to win the fight, whether it's 3 rounds to 2. What do you have to say to all these critics to say George has to finish the fight?
You have the number one and the number two guy in the world. You have the two best guys on the planet as welterweights. It's hard to put these guys away at this level. Anyone who can get a small upper hand in the fight, that's all that you need. He needs to just hold on to that belt. It's his belt. No one's able to take it away from him, despite whatever criticism people have about George and how he performs. The truth is, no one's been able to stop him from what he does. Whether people like it or not, hey, they have no choice. He's the champ. He has the belt.
You know, as soon as this interview is done, we're supposed to go in the other room there to hit the pads. Now, I know Justin will be holding the pads, Justin Bruckman. Can I get changed, or can I stay like this, or what's the deal?
You can go like this. We might have to take off the jacket. It's a little too fancy, so we got to get rid of that. Maybe the tie. I don't know.
Am I supposed to spar with you guys with this stuff on?
I think so. You know, actually, you know, you want me to leave that on so I can choke you. Yeah, it's easier to get the lapel choke in there. Yeah.
Antonio Carvalho taking on Rodrigo Damm, UFC 154, Saturday night, Bell Center in Montreal.